Hey guys, Wells Knight here, and welcome back to another episode of the Hermit Pack. In today's episode, we're going to be dealing with this. My refined storage system is getting very full, often, and I keep having to add more and more of these quantum storage units. So basically, what I have here, for anyone who doesn't know, is I've got a bunch of these quantum storage units. These things will hold an almost infinite amount of a single item. So, I don't know the exact amount that they can hold, but it's a lot. So, anytime that I get a lot of an item, like 354,000 sand, for example, or maybe that's 254, either way, when I have thousands upon thousands of something, I make a quantum storage unit for it, so that it can hold all of that without taking up all the space in my refined storage system. However, I currently have, let's see, 7 by 4, 28 of these quantum storage units, and my refined storage system, as you can see, still very, very full. So I want to deal with that today once and for all. So what I've been working on a little bit between episodes is clearing out a space for us to do that. Down this hallway where we set up our void ore miner last episode. Oh, also, I made a void resource miner because I noticed towards the end of that episode that you can't get mica without it. You can't actually get that from over here. So I made one of these between episodes. It's the same room design and everything as the ore miner. So I did that. But anyway, I cleared out a space over here, and this is going to essentially be our storage room where we store all the things. And it looks pretty terrible right now, but that's what we're going to be working on in this episode. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to make a whole bunch of quantum storage units. I'm going to make a full stack of them. And I also want to hold some fluids in here. So I'm just going to make like 8 quantum tanks, I think. We're going to hold various different things in there, probably lava, water, probably creosote oil, and any other fluids that I find that I'm using often. We're going to have some fluid stored over here as well. So the way that this is basically laid out, we're going to have our main refined storage controller and drives and all that kind of stuff in this middle section right here. And then over on this section, we're going to have a whole bunch of quantum storage units. Now, I should probably run and get some... There we go. I should probably run and get some hardened stone brick. Why do I not have any hardened stone brick in there? Is it all in some... Aha! I was going to say, I knew I had some. So let's lay this out. And I think what we'll do is we'll have some kind of a design where, like, these are going to be walls, right? And they'll probably go probably 5 high. And then we can have 9x9 chunks of quantum storage tanks or quantum storage units. So, for example, it would look something like that. And why are my block sounds so quiet? Oh, because I have them turned way down. There, that's much better. So we'll have like 9 quantum storage units there. And then here, we'd have another 9. And we're just kind of recessing them in the thing a little bit to make it look a little bit better, right? So we'll do something like that. And those will basically go all the way around the room. And that will give us a pretty fair amount of quantum storage units. Although, let's see, 9, 9, 9, 9, that would be 36. That actually won't be that many. Maybe we add 3 more on each side, like this. and then have the hardened stone come up on this side. Like that, because then that would give us, what would that be, 15 per wall? Or per wall space, I guess? However you want to say it. So maybe we do something like this. Take our quantum storage units and put those in like so. Yeah, I think that's a lot better. Also, I'm not entirely certain that I'm going to be using these hardened stone bricks. We may swap. In fact, I don't think I'm going to. I don't think I'm going to have this room be the same block palette as the rest of the base. I think this room's going to be a bit more high tech. Maybe similar to like what we did in our RF Tools transporter room. But anyway, the first thing that I need to do is get all of this stuff in place, and that's going to take me a little while. So let me get all the drives and quantum storage stuff in place, and then I will come right back to you. All right, guys, I am back. So I've got the drives and all the quantum storage units in place. We're going to have more disk drives along this wall, but what I need to do temporarily so that this thing works is I need to power this ME system. So we're going to say the backside will be output, and that should light all this up. And I need to make myself a dimensional transceiver, like big time. So I'm going to need a few different things for this. I think we'll need an octatic capacitor, which means I'm going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those. So I can make, you know what, let's just make 2. Let's make a couple right off the bat. And then for this guy, I'm going to need, some of those. We're just going to make 2-dimensional transceivers because I use them all the time anyway. So solarium, Enderman head. Ooh, I'm actually running really low on solarium. I should probably make some more of that pretty soon. Let's grab 2 Enderman heads. We need silicon and a vibrant alloy ingot. There we go. And then let's go stack of soul sand and a stack of gold so I can make more solarium because I'm almost out of it. But let me run this up. Let me make the dimensional transceivers, and then we'll have a way to power our system down here so we can actually get some stuff done. All right, guys, I am back. I think we're good to make the dimensional transceiver. I think we have everything we need. So let's toss all of this stuff in here. There we go. And I should be able to make 2. Yeah. Good. Okay, now we can get rid of this battery. And I suppose I could actually just put the dimensional transceiver right there and go to power, receive. And there we go. That'll keep this guy powered with what we need. So that's good. That's definitely good. And I'll just toss my extra receiver into there. And you know what? Let's toss this energy cube in there as well. So that should be good. Okay, now, as far as design goes, there's a few things that we're going to need as well. We're going to need a ton of external storage things, which I don't... I thought I had a whole bunch. Okay, well, whatever. So if we look... Oh, and you know what? We need this to be... JEI synchronized, like so, sort by name and D-sure. That's fine. Okay, so now we go external storage. Much better. Let's make a ton of these, because we're going to need a ton of them. And then, what I get to do is... I'm almost tempted to take this thing offline just for a little bit. Just long enough for us to get some of these up and running, because I want to get the, what is it, 28 or whatever quantum storage units that we already have. I want to get them put into this system and quickly, and I don't want any more items coming in while we do that. So maybe that's what we should do, is just take the refined storage system offline temporarily. I've got a bunch of external storage things. Let's make sure I've got some cables, because we're going to need those too. And then I think we'll be okay. So let's just run... Oh, that's external storage. Here we go. Let's just run this cable back here, like this. So that'll work. Okay. And I'm just going to put this guy right there for lighting. So that should work. All right. So now I get to take this guy offline, and we're going to go and I'm going to move all those things from upstairs down here. That's going to take me a little bit, guys. So I'll be back with you in just a sec. All right, guys, I am back, and I got the vast majority of this stuff done. So now each of these quantum storage units that actually has something in the item frame also has the, well, associated thing in the item frame in the quantum storage unit. So it's working out pretty well. You can see my my disk drives are now much, much more available than they were. I have plenty of space now, which is good. And yeah, now I do want to set up a couple more of these, and I think there's really only like two more that I need to set up. And then we'll add more things as needed. So, like, if we set up a, I don't know, what would be a good example? Say we set up a farm to get us cactus. We could add cactus to one of these and then store an infinite amount of it. So we'll have some open ones that we can use as needed. But pretty much everything here in this top section... everything that has over like 5,000 of the things, I have a quantum storage unit for, with the exception of ores, iron ore, copper ore, et cetera, and that's because I'm going to set up a separate thing for those. So I did want to show you guys, though, how to get items from these disk drives into the quantum storage unit. So we are going to do one of them together, and I'm going to use this solidified experience. So let's say we want solidified experience to go in this one up here. So I'm just putting, oh, that's a problem. Okay, yeah, I'm just putting the solidified experience in the item frame and then throwing it in the quantum storage unit behind. And then we come back here. I need a little bit more space. Let's just kind of get that out. And actually, we're going to have to clear some space over here, too. And we've got a little bit of a challenge on this side, because as you can see here, this actually runs into a wall of something. On the other side of this wall is my cow and carrot farms and all that kind of stuff. So I actually don't have all that much free space over here, but I do have enough that we can get this done. So we said up here, solidified experience. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a couple of cables. There we go. And we're just going to run this over here. Like so. Now, as I eventually, I plan to have all of these full with things. But for now, let's just put. And you know what? We'll fill up these three things first. So for now, we put an exporter here. We grab one solidified experience and we tell the exporter to start exporting those things. Now, that's going very slowly. So we'll add some upgrades to it and it'll go much faster. And we can make it go even faster than that if we want to use a Torturino, and then it flies by. So what that's doing is it's exporting all of that item from my drives to the quantum storage unit, which is what we want. Then once it's done, once the number stops moving, you just get rid of that guy, throw an external storage on there, and set it to a higher priority. And the big thing is you want to make sure you set it to a high priority. So now all of this solidified experience you see is in that quantum storage tank. And that's what I've been doing for basically the last 45 minutes or so to get all of the stuff into a quantum storage tank or whatever. So I'm going to do a couple more. I think I'm going to have one for obsidian. I probably should have one for soul sand and gravel. And I know I want one for ender pearls right here. Even though we don't have a ton of ender pearls, that's something I intend to change in the relatively near future. So let me get more. Let me get a couple more of these done, and then I'll come right back to you. All right, guys, I am back. So I think everything that I want to have stored in mass quantities, for now at least, I have done. So now it's time to turn our attention to taking this room that looks absolutely horrible and making it look not absolutely horrible. So let's grab some alabaster, because I'm thinking I want kind of a modern, well, maybe not even modern would be the right word, but I want a much more bright color palette than what we're using in most of the base. I want this room to have kind of this like science fiction vibe to it, like technology and all sorts of cool stuff like that. So I am going to make some laboratory blocks from chisel. And we'll see if we can maybe do something with those. So let's go in here. Let's grab our chisel. Let's see what kind of a texture we have here as options. And I'm looking for something. Oh, that's not bad. That's also not bad, though. So maybe we'll just stick with the default ones. Like, that's super easy. But I like the default ones. And then we'll just right-click that. So we can change these guys. And since we had this kind of hardened stone here, it should be pretty easy to change. In fact, we could even make this bigger. And we can get basically the whole thing all at once. Which totally works. There we go. So we've got something like that going. Now, right here... Oh, that's not the laboratory block. Right here, we're going to bring one of those up as well. Because remember I said before, I want to have multiple disk drives here, but right now we don't have, right now we've just got a handful of disk drives, and I don't really need a whole lot more than this. So I think right here we'll do maybe something like this, or maybe even like that. How's that look? That doesn't look very good. I think we need some contrast there. So I think we should use a different block. So let's see what we got. Maybe we can use the alabaster, which does look amazing. I mean, I really do love this block. It's a great looking block. Maybe we do something like that. And then this can maybe come over like so or something. Now, needs depth. Definitely needs depth. Maybe we bring that up. And we do the same thing right here. And then we get rid of those. How's that look? That doesn't look too bad. Now, it's very dark at the moment because I don't have any lighting in here, but I think that'll do. Now, as for pillars... Let's see what we have for vertical pillar options. These ones are pretty good. Let's make a bunch of those. And I think we're going to put those down right here like this. Because we want those kind of in the corners a little bit. on these spots where I've marked them out. So we'll just kind of get those going right there. I still haven't decided what we're going to do in here for a floor, but we're going to have to do something. That's too high. There we go. And here we'll go like a so. Like so. Like so. And like so. All right, so that looks good. Now this wall, I don't know what's going to go here yet, but it's going to have to be something other than quantum storage tanks and stuff, because you can see right here, this wall actually feeds into that room. So I can't really put anything there. What was that noise? That was weird. I don't know what that was. Anyway, so let's go back to our chisel and let's see here. Oh, that's not what I wanted. There we go. That's alabaster. Grab. I thought I just chiseled a whole bunch of... There we go. That was a little funny. Weird. Whatever. Let's maybe do something like that. And then it'll line up. It'll still, like, look similar to the other stuff. But then maybe what we can do is chisel one stack there, one stack there, and one stack there, right? So we'll have these three different blocks that all kind of feed in a different direction. And we can maybe do something like that, which I think will look, I think that'll look good. Then we need lamps of some sort. We're going to need lighting. And I've got a whole bunch of these white lamps left. So maybe we put that there. And just put it at this level. Oh. In all of these pillars. To give us a little bit of light. I think that would be really good. Oh, not there. You go there. You go there, there, and that looks good. So we just gotta shift right click them to turn them all on. And that should give us a decent amount of light. So now I think I can get rid of most of these lights, these fake ones that I put in. Oh, forgot to turn you on. There we go. So that's good. Go back to our laboratory blocks right here. And let's just put those guys down like so. And over here as well. And I should be able to do something back here on all three of these, or in both of these sections. I should be able to do some sort of a design. Do we have the Futura blocks? We do. Which are made... Oh, that's easy. That's super easy. All right, let's make a stack of those. And let's chisel that into... Ooh, that's psychedelic. That's a little trippy. That I like better. Let's do that. And maybe here we do something like that. And then kind of the same deal here, right? So we'll have these like wall sections going each direction. And it can kind of... Is that the right one? Yes. Okay. So we'll do that. And that. And then up here we do the opposite. And we can turn these panels into something actually like functional later if we need to. Right now, we don't really need to. So for now, we can just kind of do, you know, this sort of thing. Just to do something with that space, which I think looks good. Now here, I want alabaster. Let's grab a stack of that. And we're just going to build this up and over like that. And then I think we're probably going to put another one of those doors like we did on the other, the entrance to our teleportation room. I think we're going to use one of those iron doors because I like the way that that thing looks. Let's take a look at doors, though. What other options do I have? We've got regular iron doors, which look kind of bad. There's no, like, laboratory door, unfortunately. I think the reinforced door is the closest we have, which I can live with it, but I prefer something different. Let's see. Let's go back to our laboratory blocks for a minute. And let's just grab all of these and see if I go here, we can just chisel all of that. There we go. And now let's do one of these as kind of like a laboratory floor. And then we'll just bring it this way. And I'm wrapping it around this because I want to do something with the center of this room to kind of make it more interesting rather than just like a flat sort of a thing. So we're going to do that. And let's fill those in as well. Okay. How does that look? That looks pretty good, I think. This looks terrible, but we'll deal with that momentarily. Right now it looks pretty bad. But as far as like floor goes, I think this looks pretty good. We just need to do something with this right here. So what I'm thinking, right, is we're going to take iron trap doors, and we're going to make a bunch of these. We're also going to now get rid of this cobblestone border because we don't need that anymore. That thing can go away. Like so. We'll put that in here, and we'll go back to the Futura blocks, and let's make a few. And I just want to chisel all of those for the moment. And then what we're going to do here is I'm going to make lines running across like this. Oh, it's not an odd number. Oh, yeah, it is. I'm just an idiot and can't count. Okay, whatever. That's fine. So we'll do that. Then I want glowstone. Because I want some glowstone in here, I think. Well, then again, we could go back to these and do... I mean, that really wouldn't give us any lighting, per se. But that's super psychedelic. That, I don't really like that either. Actually, yeah, that'd work really nicely, now that I think about it, because it would be... Just kidding, that has some crazy graphical glitch associated with it. Never mind, that is not going to look good. Let's try something different. Maybe we try this one? Let's try that one out. How's that look? Yeah. Yeah, that'll work. The idea is just to put something really flashy underneath here to really kind of make the part underneath stand out a bit. And then I think what we'll probably do is, like, here. What was that? Three? One, two, three. Here. And here. I think I'm going to put some glowstone in the floor there. So there's not really a whole lot for, like, super modern glowstone. But I think this might work. If we do that, 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 and that. Like, I think that's good. And that'll keep everything really well lit up. And then what we can do is just take these trap doors. I guess we have to put them all down manually. Unless, can I... Oh, I totally can. If I hold shift, I can use the builder's wand. That's fantastic. All right, I do need more iron trapdoors, though. Iron trapdoors. Give me a bunch more. There we go. And we can just bring that all the way across. So when you come in, you're going to have like this kind of cool effect where there's stuff underneath the floor, but it's kind of hidden at the same time underneath these trap doors. So it's like this rainbow color type thing. I think it looks pretty cool. I think it'll work really nice. Now, we also need a ceiling in here for sure. So for a ceiling, I think we'll just keep it really simple. We'll go laboratory blocks. Let's just make a bunch of those. And then I think we'll just go with this up here. How will that look? As a ceiling? Nope. I changed my mind. We're going to go with the same one that we did for the floor. There we go. And I think that'll look significantly better. We do need lighting back here, though, because technically this is all spawnable, which we don't want. Obviously, we don't want stuff spawning in our back, in our ceilings and stuff. So let's just bring that over and across like so. Give us that. That looks good. And then we just have to close that off. And that is basically it. I like it. I actually really like it. Still not entirely sold on this part here, though. Maybe what we do is we take this alabaster and move it up like this. Oop. There. There. And then you can have alabaster stairs, right? Like if I do that, I could put a stair here and here. That doesn't look too bad. I think I could probably live with that. I think that's a good look, actually. Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm good with that. Unfortunately, though, guys, I am most certainly out of time for this episode. So, my friends, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.